Hi everyone and welcome. Today we are going to show you some highlights of what's in process mining and process AI for Infinity 24.1 release. My name is Luis Santos. I work as a product manager in Pega Process Mining, and with me is Andy Bober.
Hi everybody, my name is Andy Bober. I'm Senior Director of Product Management as part of the Pega Platform team.
All right. So I'm super excited to be here today and discuss what is new. So let's start with Pega Process Mining. Last year, our market innovations were driven by a build for change philosophy. The idea was to promote a business self-optimization, adapting quickly to change, automating at scale, and delivering seamless experiences. We needed to help organizations integrate these giant processes and automate manual tasks in different areas like customer services and operations. So we organized their existing processes, environments, and teams on our unified platform, providing an end-to-end visibility. We have introduced a process mining solution to enhance this end-to-end experience and promote transparency. It is an easy-to-use, insightful, scalable solution, and it's accessible to everyone. You don't need to have a background in process analysis or a very specific skills in order to derive value from it. So we make it possible to discover, monitor, and improve processes, identifying bottlenecks, reworks, and inefficiencies, and wonder what circumstances they happen. We can then analyze process from different perspectives and clearly understand the points of friction that lead to unnecessary costs, loss of revenue, or poor customer experiences. And with Infinity 24.1, we want our clients to be able to do more and unlock value faster. To do that, we focus on enhancing our Pega connector capabilities, debuting a new connector for Snowflake, and improving the overall performance of our application. On Infinity 23, we introduce our Pega connector, which enables clients to easily obtain data from Pega applications and analyze it in our process mining tool. With this, we enable clients to visualize status and stage changes throughout their processes and select relevant attributes from the process execution to enrich their analysis and identify opportunity for improvements. Now on Infinity 24.1, we enhanced the activities identification and we expand the supported event types, providing additional layers of detail to a process. With that, users will have more clarity when analyzing their process, allowing for a better decision-making, accelerating time to value. We also made the usage of status and stage changes optional to promote more flexibility and simplify the analysis. Also, knowing that process may span multiple systems, we provide various source connectors to deliver end-to-end visibility across Pega and third-party systems. And with that in mind, we are introducing a new connector for Snowflake and enabling data extraction from existing sources. That simplifies data collection, promoting improved performance, flexibility, and scalability. In addition, we have made performance improvements in our clusters and on key application features such as simulation and other JDBC connectors, providing a better overall experience. So Pega Process Mining is an awesome tool and it gives us a world of possibilities. But a common question that comes to mind whenever we find a problem or a possibility of improvement is what to do next? How can I take action now? And I believe that is exactly where Process AI can help us, right, Andy?
Thank you, Luis. Process mining and process AI are both part of a closed-loop continuous optimization system built on top of the Pega platform. In short, organizations use process mining to find problems, like a high amount of reworks that they didn't know existed, and use process AI to inject real-time knowledge into any case to improve their outcomes. As a level set, process AI infuses automation with real-time workflow AI, along with event processing, so you can deliver decision intelligence to business processes across your estate. Process AI leverages core Pega capabilities, such as those we use for code deployment, and stands out for how easy it is to apply analytics to your production case types and applications, all at massive scale. Out of the box, Process AI enables you to do things like predict the likelihood a case will hit its SLA, evaluate event streams for abnormalities that you can then use to trigger exception cases, and even use natural language processing to determine which person or team is best suited to work a given case, and then have the system routed to them automatically. To better understand why Process AI is important, let's look at the types of questions you can answer with Process AI. Are you wasting time on easy cases? Is new work getting stale while it waits for review? Are you paying fines for missing targets? Are you manually triaging incoming events or maybe even incoming emails? Process AI is all about improving the efficiency and effectiveness of your business processes. Now let's take a look at a generic business process to highlight some of these common use cases. Cases may go through an auto adjudication decision where there could be manual steps for resolving that case. Process AI can find patterns based on all data and dimensions in your application, and it automatically updates in real time as each individual case works its way through. You can use AI probabilities to do things like decide or help inform the decision about whether a case should be audited or can be auto-resolved with the benefit of new information, say a case that has a low probability of fraud, or determine the right team to work on it. The net result is that more cases get done faster and more efficiently, improving both your customer experience and your business results. Now let's shift gears and take a look at a few net new features before we wrap up. First up is the custom outcome prediction. This provides a ton of flexibility as it lets you predict virtually any element of an application. For example, the likely payout for a claim or the probability that a case needs to go to a specialist for review. Having this knowledge in advance lets you change both the course and the outcome of any case for the better. We'll walk through this just to show how easy it is to set up using a complaints workflow. Here we are going to use Process AI to predict the likelihood a customer agrees with the proposed resolution and use that information to route cases where we think the customer will disagree to a high-risk handling queue. As you can see, we simply have to select case management prediction. We give that prediction a name. We then select from the predefined set of potential outcomes, for example, case completion, claims fraud, but this is a custom outcome. We give that outcome a name, and then we select the object that we are aiming to predict. Now with this in hand, we go back to our application, and we're going to add a new routing logic here. So we're going to use business logic and configure this so that whenever an individual in any given workflow is predicted to have a high probability of not agreeing to the outcome, in that case, we are going to route those cases to a new high-risk queue. And to do that, we've created a new work queue, high-risk cases. We are selecting customer agreement probability. If that value is relatively low, in this case, we'll say it's less than 20%, it will get routed to this work queue. We simply then have to set up the alternate work queue, where all the other work, the ones where we expect customers will agree, will go to. And it's as simple as that. We're really in the home stretch now, not a whole lot more to cover, but just a few quick things to highlight before we break. First up, we've updated our Google Vertex AI integration. As you can see here, we support a number of different provider models and cloud providers as well, including AWS SageMaker and Google Vertex. We've simply updated with Google to make sure that we are current and can support their latest and greatest integrations. Also, on the lines of Google, we have also added support for Google PubSub. We've been seeing more requests for this, and this is an event streaming platform that provides capabilities that are similar to what you might see with Kafka and Kinesis. and just provides a little more flexibility in terms of the providers that you can integrate process AI with. That's a really, really quick overview of process AI and some of the cool things that are new in process AI in Pega Infinity 24. There's lots of ways for you to learn more, of course. I'm going to highlight a few things here that are worth taking a look at. First up, there is a new Decision Management Essentials course. This just became available in December. And if you are looking at deploying directly or on behalf of your clients, process AI, this is really valuable background for you to have as you delve into that work. Secondly, we've also refreshed the documentation for process AI. I find it to be much easier to use and suggest that you take a look at it as well. And then finally, we have updated the process AI sample application to be consistent with Pega Infinity 24.1. So that's really it. Thanks again for joining us today. As you can see, both process mining and process AI can provide a lot of net new value on top of your investment in Pega. And Infinity 24 is a really exciting new release for us. For our clients, process AI and process mining are effective game changers, and we encourage you to check them both out. Thanks again for listening in. Please be sure to take advantage of our online resources and your Pega account team to learn more about Pega Process Mining and Pega Process AI. Thank you.